EVs are impractical. They don't have a lot of range. They all look blue. On top of that, they are not value for money. They're just so overpriced. Well, that's exactly where this EV proves everyone wrong. This is the Hyundai Ioniq 5, and I think this is a super underrated EV that deserves a lot more attention. I mean, this looks unique. The range is mind-boggling. The interiors are out of the world. And what makes this even more special are the little details that everyone missed out on. Well, I'll be talking about little details throughout the video, so let's go. See, I've been driving this for a week now, and the big takeaway with the Ioniq 5 is that EVs can be fun to drive while bringing in the premium experience. I say it's fun to drive because this is an EV that puts out 214 bhp of power and a torque of 350 newton meters to the rear wheels. Now, this does not look like a big and hefty car, but this is how it looks alongside the Endeavor and the i10 Neos. So yeah, it's fairly big, and on paper, 214 bhp on a fairly big car does not sound too quick, but if you ask me, when I put the foot on the pedal, it very quickly takes me to triple digit speeds. I mean, it takes off really nicely, and this is an EV, so you've got all the 350 newton meters of torque, and there's no lag whatsoever. And this is me talking about the normal mode, but the sports mode, it just adds more fun to the experience, and the eco mode is also very responsive enough. Look, the quickness apart, what makes the Ioniq 5 driving experience really, really impressive is the suspension. I mean, this is an EV that seems to be designed for Indian roads. I've been using this as my daily driver from my home to the office, and my route includes a lot of speed breakers and a couple of bad road stretches. And with the Ioniq 5, the experience is on a whole another level. I was able to take on speed breakers without even braking, and that's impressive considering the big 20-inch wheels and the large wheelbase. A special mention to the ground clearance of 176mm, which is sufficient, and I had no worries on big speed breakers. The suspension here just eats up bad roads without any problems. It's just really, really good. The cornering is also good, although you do feel a bit of roll, but braking is one area where this is really, really good. I mean, it's basically a combo of the front and rear disc brakes and regenerative braking, and it's super responsive. For people who don't know, regenerative braking allows the vehicle to store energy when you hit the brake pedal, thus maximizing the overall range. Now, remember I said little details? So there are multiple levels of regenerative braking in the Ioniq 5. There's auto, which works with ADAS, or you can change things from level 0 to level 3, which you can set using the paddles. You can also long press on the left paddle to put regenerative braking to the max. Now, I found the level 1 to hit the sweet spot because it just feels more natural, similar to what you get on an internal combustion engine. Now, one of the coolest features of this car is that you can drive this without hitting the brake pedal. Let me show you. See, I can just long press on the right pedal to set the car to i-pedal mode, and this relies on smart regenerative braking. So all I need to use is use the accelerator pedal, and the moment I move my foot off the accelerator, the Ioniq will brake. It's an interesting feature. Anyway, EVs are all about being efficient, and this is again where the little details come in. This is an active air flap which opens up automatically to cool down the car's batteries and motors, and when it comes to efficiency, it just closes down to reduce the drag. The spoiler is also designed in a way to make sure that the air passes from the top and through in here, and what this does is it reduces the vortex from the back of the car to keep the car more stable and fluidic. Fluidic? Get it? Never mind. The 20-inch wheels here have a look that I'm not a big fan of, but these have a flat front surface which reduces the aerodynamic drag, which in turn helps with the car's efficiency. That's not all, the underbody is also completely flat to make sure that the car literally glides at higher speeds. Now, let's talk about the range, which is something that matters a lot when it comes to EVs. Now, the Ioniq 5 has an ARAI rated range of up to 630 kilometers on full charge, and that's a lot. But in the real world, I would say the range is around 450, 500 kilometers, which is still awesome for a powerful EV like this. And I also like that the range that the EV shows in the MID is mostly accurate with a give and take of 20 kilometers. I also noticed that there was no overnight drain in the battery, and when it comes to charging, it supports universal AC and DC chargers. The charger Hyundai bundles with the car is an 11 kilowatt AC charger that takes around 7 hours to fully charge the EV. There's also support for up to 350 kilowatt chargers. Now, we obviously couldn't find any 350 kilowatt chargers, but there were a lot of 50 kilowatt and 60 kilowatt chargers around. We did try out a 30 kilowatt charger, and we put the Ioniq to charge at 51%. And after an hour exactly, the EV was at 89% charge. And the price for this was around 600 rupees. Now, another little detail on the Ioniq 5 is that the 72.6 kilowatt hour battery on this EV not only powers the car, it can power a lot of your devices. This has the vehicle to load feature that provides 3.6 kilowatt of power for your devices. See, there's an onboard socket on the rear that can be used for things like charging your laptop or camera, and this is actually useful. I have my laptop plugged in, and you can see on the screen here how much power the charger is taking. Yeah, the MacBook charger isn't making a big impact on this. And I also like that you can limit this to a certain percentage. So I can set it to 50% so that when the EV is at 50% charge, this is automatically cut off. Apart from the socket inside, there's a socket here outside, but this requires a converter, which Hyundai bundles with the car. And this can be useful for, say, when you're camping and you need the power to power your lights. I mean, I'm not sure I'm ever going camping on an EV, but this is a good feature. I know. Now this is an EV, so it's also very silent, but it does generate an artificial sound on the outside to let pedestrians know, although it's not very loud. The shifter is also unique. It's here attached to the steering wheel on the right, and it's an unusual position, but I was able to get used to it very quickly. And one thing to note, all the buttons in this EV have great tactile feedback, be it the pass light lever, the drive mode button, or the buttons on the door handles, everything. Yeah, the buttons here scream premium, and that brings me to what I said at the start, that this brings a premium experience, and there are two reasons why I said that. One, this is a looker. No matter where I took this car, it turned a lot of heads, and that's mainly because this looks like nothing out there. Two, the feel in this cabin. I mean, just look at this. This looks beautiful, and if you ask me, better than a lot more expensive cars out there. I mean, the interior of this versus, say, the interiors on the X1 or the GLA, which one do you think looks better? I mean, the white leather seats, this two-spoke wheel with a flat bottom, the massive glass roof, the super cool ambient lighting all around, the bright displays all add to the premiumness of this cabin. It just feels super airy, and a lot of these parts are using recyclable materials. And it's not just the looks, the Ioniq 5 packs in all the premium features. There's also a 360-degree cameras here, and the quality is really, really good. I can pan on the screen, and it's super responsive, as you can see, and this is just a godsend for parking. There's also BlueLink, wired CarPlay, and Android Auto, and 8-speaker system from Bose, and ADAS Level 2 features, so there's smart cruise control with stop and go, front collision warning and emergency braking, blind spot collision warning, and a lot more. This also obviously does have the power seats, and with the press of a single button, I can do this. Both these seats also get heating and cooling, although I would have liked buttons for this rather than controlling it via the screen. The rear seats support power sliding, but the recline has to be manually adjusted, and these seats only get heating. There's also memory function for all the seats. Apart from this, this has a power tailgate with height adjustment, and the boot space is around 500 liters, although do note that you don't get a spare tire with this, just this puncture repair kit. There's a lot of storage everywhere else though. There's this 57-liter trunk on the front, there's this center console with storage up top and bottom, and this also has wireless charging here, and this whole center console can be slided. The glove box is also more of a drawer, and it slides like this. Look, I can go on and on talking about the features, but the point is the Hyundai Ioniq 5 is an EV that costs 45 lakh rupees. Yeah, that sounds a lot. But after driving this EV, I can tell you that this car packs in all the features you expect in that price range. Honestly, I'm still looking for those big compromises. I mean, it has all the EV issues, like you need to plan things according to charger locations. There is a bit of anxiety attached to the battery percentage, but this is a problem with all EVs. And if I really had to nitpick, there's no wireless Android Auto or CarPlay support. The MID could have been more customizable. The center console is a bit cluttered, but then again, these aren't big compromises if you ask me. And overall, the Ioniq 5 is an EV that's just really fun to drive, packed with useful features and tech while looking supremely premium. Anyway, I want to know from you guys, the Hyundai Ioniq 5 at 45 lakhs, makes sense? Comment down below.